Okay, in the last video, I showed you how to do the two-layer, pretty basic. But now I'm going to show you how to do something a little bit more complex with three layers. Now, three layers is good because when you're looking at a photo, if you want to get really down into the nitty-gritty, you have your background, which is your shadows, you have your mids, which is the grays, usually, and you have your highlights, which is the whites. And that's essential, like, when it comes down to a photo. So having three layers is like the minimum requirement for making something look realistic. The more layers you put, the more realistic it looks. But then again, you're just adding to something that you already have. So the minimum for realism is shadows, mids, and highlights. So that's three layers. So let's do the three layers. This is a camera. Duh. But it's a good camera. And not only is it good because it's pretty badass in the real world, but it's pretty badass looking, and I can make a really cool stencil out of it. So I'm gonna save this and open it in Photoshop. Okay, very nice.
Ooh, fucking tired.
If you know Photoshop a little bit, you might want to expand this by changing the canvas size. So you have some room to work with, like that. Okay, same step. Desaturate it, make it black and white. Go back to filter, and go to artistic cutout. Now, let's change the levels to 3. So, if you noticed, I went from 2, which looks pretty dull, to 3, which looks more like the photo. Now watch when I go to 4. Not that much of a difference, huh? The threshold is at 3. Edge simplicity, put that at around 3. You want to have edge simplicity where it's not like this, because then you don't know what the hell it is, but then again you don't want it at 1, because it gets really complex, and you gotta cut all that out, or, you know, fix it with the brush. So, a good middle is okay. So I'm going to put it at 2, and the fidelity, leave it at 1. It's okay. Okay, basically, with this, you have all the parts, right? You have the background, you have the grays, which are the mids, there's a lot of them, and you have the whites, which is this shadow right here. Now, this could take a while to cut, so I'm going to tell you really quickly, you don't need stuff like that, or like that, or like that. Some of the stuff, though, you do need because it's kind of essential. Because if you take out too much of it, you won't know what the hell you're looking at. So it's kind of needed. That's why we have shadows. Now, it's the same step as before with the two-layer. You're going to print out 3 copies. Remember, however many layers you're doing, that's how many copies you have to print out. So 3 copies. So when you cut out the first part, you're going to cut out the base, and you're going to spray this over with your black spray paint for the base, because it takes up the majority of the photo, the stencil. And when you spray that, you're going to get an image that looks like that, you know, just for example. I'm trying to be really quick here. When you're done with that, you want to do the mids. You always want to remember the cake idea I told you about. You always want to work from the ground up, so you want to work from the biggest color down to the smallest color. Because think about it, if you start with the whites, and you fuck up, and you kind of like, you're kind of off with the stencil, you're going to get like, this is going to be covered, and you're like, great. But since you're working with the bigger part first, there's room to kind of mess up, and be a little sloppy, just a little bit. So always work from the ground up. And since this is a little bit more time, I'm going to pause the video short. And I'm gonna do this in the next video. So stop this video. Well, don't stop it. Ugh, whatever. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Just go to the next video, and I'll show you how to continue this. So stop now.